When Julie Riffe was a college student between 1974 and 1978, she ran for Morehead State University. In fact, she was the first woman to run women's track and field at MSU.
And Coach Dawson came to my house and saw me at different track meets and said, "We're going to start a women's track team at Morehead. And we would like you to be the one that helps us build that." So I looked at different options, and I liked the idea that Morehead was only an hour away from home and that I was familiar with it. And so I chose Morehead.
The Ashland native went on to become the first Eagle woman to qualify for the AIAW Track and Field Championships. In the years to follow, she would run all over the world, advocating for and speaking out for those in need.
I've always had a love for missions, and have thought over the years I was probably supposed to be a missionary. So when I had the opportunity to travel to Ecuador with a medical mission team in Ashland, I chose to do that, and I chose to take my children with me. They were 11 and 12. I wanted them to see what the world was like out there and not just what it's like in our hometown.
A graduate of Morehead State's nursing program, Riffe eventually became a nurse practitioner and midwife and established her own business in West Virginia.
Lots of things fell in place, and I've always relied on God to give me direction, and through lots of prayers and support of my family, my husband, my parents, we were able to buy a building and renovate it, and then we opened Women's Health Services in Barbersville. My goal was to pay it off in 2 years, but I paid it off in 18 months. God really blessed the practice. His hands were on my practice, and I was able to take care of women who I had delivered, their mothers, grandmothers, and then the girls that I delivered, I took care of them. So it was a continuity of care.
The contacts she made in the medical profession and the need Riffe saw to bring healthcare services to troubled parts of the world led her to involvement in overseas missions.
We went to Ecuador and worked with the Quechua Indians and provided medical care to them in villages that a lot of the Quechuans had never had medical care at all. And that was very dear to me. That was I was able to do basic medical care, and that was very fulfilling. So as I had other opportunities, I went back to Ecuador several times. But when the tsunami occurred in the Indian Ocean, I was asked to go with a group that had been to India, and we were there a couple of months after the tsunami occurred. And that was an incredible trip. There was so much need. The Indian people are beautiful people. I enjoy getting to learn about other cultures. And I think that's something that I go back to Morehead and think about how, and even Coach Dawson, he taught us to love each other equally, no matter what your race. We're all humans. We are all the same.
Though Riffe was proud of the humanitarian work in which she and her colleagues were engaged, a catastrophe 8 years ago underscored just how vital those services can be.
We went to Haiti within 2 weeks of the earthquake. And as you know, the earthquake of 2010, there were anywhere from 100 to 300,000 people killed instantly. Some things that I don't believe everyone is aware of: the main medical school and main nursing schools there were collapsed, and they lost most of their students. So that had a big impact on me as well. So we got there, and during that week, I was able to get together some of the most experienced physicians and healthcare team, nurses, nurse practitioners. We all went together and worked probably 18 to 20 hours a day, slept very little. We had death all around us.
But life too, toward the end of a difficult week, she delivered a baby boy, and slowly the Haitian people began to rebuild. The experience prompted Riffe to form Tri-State Medical Missions, which is dedicated to delivering health care to people everywhere, and she serves as director. As one whose life has been devoted to caring for others for nearly four decades, early this year, Julie Riffe found herself in a role reversal. She was diagnosed with cancer.
I'm very encouraged. I've never been angry at God. I've been sad because my life has changed, but it hasn't changed in a horrible way. I don't want people to feel sorry for me. I believe that God's blessed me with an incredible life.
Julie Riffe is revered as a pioneer in women's health and now takes her place in the Morehead State University Alumni Hall of Fame.
I've been very blessed to be able to travel not only across the country but in different parts of the world. And I've met a lot of educated, uneducated, lots of different people. There is no place in this world that I would have rather had my foundation for my education than Morehead State University. It was the right university by far. It was large enough, it was small enough. The setting was beautiful, and the values that it taught and still teaches, I just treasure.